हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल द लेंस इंडिया प्रोफेशनल फोटोग्राफी। आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर एंजॉयिंग माय वीडियोस अबाउट द बेसिक फोटोग्राफी एंड वी हैव कवर्ड लॉट मेनी टॉपिक्स इन आवर सेशंस इन माय वीडियोस व्हिच आई हैव ऑलरेडी पोस्टेड ऑन द यूट्यूब। सो वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट टॉपिक नाउ व्हाट आई एम गोइंग टू कवर टुडे इज द फोकसिंग सिस्टम ऑफ द कैमरा। सो दिस विल हेल्प यू टू कैप्चर द फोटोज प्रिसाइजली शार्प एंड the good photographs where you will be able to achieve the control on the focus on the subject. So in this video I'll try to explain based on the Nikon camera which I am using, and of course more or less the focusing system remains same in almost all cameras. Of course the nomenclature will differ based on the camera manufacturer to manufacturer. So let's start with our focusing system study today. So mainly when we are talking about the focusing system which is available in the camera, so we have two types of focusing system. One is called as the auto focusing system, another is called as the manual focusing system. So manual focusing system, as the name suggests, it is very easy to understand that we need to basically rotate the focusing ring which is available on the lens and focus on the subject where the subject is placed in our frame. Okay, but when we talk about the auto focusing system, so there are multiple options which are available both in Nikon and Canon as well, and rest of the other camera brands too. So let's try to understand the auto focusing system. Okay, so right now I'm showing you my viewfinder. So before I show you the demonstration on the focusing, let's try to understand what menus are available related to the focusing in the Nikon. So if you go to the photo shooting menu in the Nikon, so you can see that the yellow color highlighted, we have one is the focusing focus mode and other is the focus area. So let's try to understand the focus mode. So when I select this menu, so we have three options available in this. So one is the autofocus AFS, that is the single autofocus, AFC, that is the continuous autofocus, and third is the manual focus. So let's try to understand this, what does it mean? So when we have this AFS selected, so what does it mean? So when we are trying to shoot the objects which are steady, so in such case we can use this AFS mode. So that means we can focus wherever our subject is and we can take the shots. When the object is moving, we have we can select this AFC mode. Okay, so that is the continuous autofocus mode, so that the camera tracks the focus on the moving object and we can capture the sharp images. The third is the manual focus. So manual focus is something when our camera is not able to focus in certain situations, that is either in the dark light situation we need to use manual focus, or probably when the object is moving too fast, in such cases the fast focusing does not take place. So we can anticipate that from the fast moving object where it is going to pass, and we can already pre-focus that area, and as soon as this object appears in the frame we can capture the photographs. So in some of the entry level cameras you will also find, instead of manual focus, additional what you can see is the AFA, that is the autofocus auto. That means the camera will automatically detect whether the subject is moving or subject is steady, and accordingly it will switch the focus mode which is available on the camera. This is particularly about the Nikon. And if we talk about Canon, so Canon has again similar three modes. They call it as a one shot focus, AI servo, and AI. So one shot is something like in Nikon it is called as the autofocus single. Another is AI servo is similar to autofocus continuous, and AI is autofocus auto. So the same functionalities are available in the Canon 2. So as of now, let us select for this demonstration purpose autofocus single. So I've selected this. Now let's move on to the next focusing parameter, which is the AF area. Okay, so if we look at this AF area which are available here, So you can see various options are available, like pinpoint AF, single point AF, wide area autofocus, small range, wide area autofocus, large zone, wide area for autofocus for the people, wide area focus for the animals, and autofocus area AF. And again, we have autofocus area AF for people and autofocus area AF for animals. Of course, this many menus may not be available in your camera, but definitely the AF area modes which are available, which might be available in your camera, is the autofocus single point, autofocus wide. So wide, you may not have so many options available, and probably AF, auto AF area. This is all also called as a dynamic autofocus range. Okay, so in most of the Nikon earlier entry level models, or probably in the high full frame cameras also, or the higher end cameras also. So similarly in Canon, you will have instead of AF area mode, Canon has named it as a autofocus area zones. So they have large zones, small zones, and something like this. So similar option is available in Canon also. So based on the shooting requirement, now just I'll explain you quickly what are these points. So if our object is steady and we want to particularly focus on a subject in the frame, so this single point focus allows us to select the particular focusing point and capture the photograph. So AF area dynamic, right now it is disabled because we have selected the autofocus single. If you remember this autofocus mode, so we have selected it AFS, that is the single point focus. Now if I shift from single AF to continuous AF, this dynamic area will get enabled. Now you can see the dynamic area AF got enabled, but now pinpoint AF focus got disabled. Okay, so this is how, based on the functionality what you're selecting, the some menu options will get enabled and some menu options will get disabled. So I'll just move back to the focus mode as a single point so that I can show you the demonstration. So a wide area, particularly if you group this wide areas, so this will allow me to select the focus points at the wider ranges. So so camera will detect the focus points in much more wider areas. Autofocus area, the camera will detect where all the contrast exists, and it will show me the focus points where all the focusing is happening. But of course, it is just detecting the contrast. Now we have one more photo function function available as auto area AF for the people. This is nothing but in simple terms, I can say it's a face detection technology. But particularly now this functionality has been much more precise than the earlier cameras. It directly focuses on the eye of the people instead of the face. And similarly, this particular AF area for animal. So you can imagine that when we are shooting wildlife or birding, the area of the eye which is covered in the total frame is very, very small. So when we are shooting wildlife photos, we can select this auto area AF for animals. So let us start with the quickly with the single point focus. I will not explain pinpoint focus and other areas because probably you may not have those functionalities available. So now this is the viewfinder, and you can see that I have arranged some object for the demonstration purpose. Of course, this is not a very clean arrangement per se, but just for understanding purpose and demonstration purpose, I have arranged these objects. So when I'm pressing the button, you can see there are some areas which are lit, right? So you can see the focus points keep on changing, right? So we have two objects in foreground and two objects in the background. So you can see the areas are differing. Okay, so now if I want to change the area, so if you see that my current focus area mode is on the auto area AF mode. Okay, so I'll shift it from the autofocus area mode to single point AF area mode. Okay, so Now I have selected the single point. Now you see there is a green square which is available. The camera is focused on this particular object which is in the foreground. Now if I don't want to focus on this first object, now I want to shift it to the object which is at the second number. So I'll just select the focus point, shift the focus point, so that you can see now the object is, my camera is focusing on the second object. But now what is happening, suppose if I don't want the objects in the foreground to be focused, I want my object which is in the background, which is the main subject, which can be the main subject rather. So I can shift my focus point and I can bring that object in the focus zone and make it sharp. But suppose if I still don't want this third object to be sharp, I want this the last object which is in the frame to be sharp. So I'll select this and I can make this object sharp. And you can see that when I'm selecting the object which is at the extreme back, the foreground subject is becoming blur. Okay, so this is how I can focus wherever I want, and I can also basically take the objects which I don't need and out of focus. Okay, so this is called in old school when we learned photography, so that time it was called as differential focusing system. Okay, nowadays normally this terminology is not used by most of the photographers, but this is nothing but the differential focusing system. So now this is about the single point. Now let's switch our mode from focus point selection from single point to wider area autofocus. So I'll just select for the explanation purpose wide area autofocus large. Okay, so let's see what happens. Okay, now when I'm selecting, now you see the green square, the area has increased. Okay, and it is automatically selecting the point where the focusing is happening. Now I can, in this mode, now this is as good as the single point focusing system, so I can shift the focusing point and I can select the area of the focusing. And you can see since I have selected now the subject in the foreground, the background subject or the background objects are becoming blur. Now what will happen, suppose if I select this as a small area. Okay, now I have selected a small area. You can see this square, the red square on the screen, the size has become small, and still I can do the single point focusing. Okay, so this is how the focusing area can be defined. Now another thing, again if I go to the wide area, suppose which is for the people, wide large for the people. Okay, and since now we do not have any people, but it will still hunt the contrast and it will show me where the focusing point is, and it will allow me to enable to focus wherever my subject is. Then if I move on to, let's say, the auto area AF. Okay, so now this is the, probably, sorry, it did not get selected. So I have selected this autofocus area mode. Now when I am in this mode, the camera will not allow me to select the focusing point. The camera will directly pick up the focusing points where it finds that is the best scene. Okay, so let's see what happens. Now you see, now camera is continuously shifting the focus from the area when I'm trying to focus, and the number of focus points which are getting enabled are also differing every time. So in such case, when the camera is not allowing me to focus wherever I want to focus on the main subject, now let's in this case assume that the people, objects in the foreground are my actually the main subject, but still here the camera is focusing in the background, and you can see every time I try to focus, it is shifting the focusing points. So in such cases, so this is one of the drawback, that when we are selecting the autofocus area in the auto mode, it is not allowing me to focus where I am supposed to focus or where my main subject is placed. Okay, so that is why normally I don't prefer to use this mode. I'll prefer to use this mode particularly when I'm shooting people. So this is one of the great functionality available in the latest camera these days. Of course, face recognition, all those also works on the similar pattern. So camera will automatically detect the face and focus on the eye. But since we have still life objects, so still the camera continues to focus in the background. You can see that. So this is how the focusing point works. So if you want to achieve the accuracy while focusing, so and when the object is not moving, it is highly recommended that we use the single point focus. When we are shooting people, so it is recommended to use this autofocus area A for the people. And as I mentioned, if you want to shoot the moving objects, if we shift from autofocus single to autofocus continuous, and still if you see the area modes which are available, still they are on, right? So still you can use any of the focusing areas whichever is available. So this will help you to take the pictures in much better way. Your main subject will always remain in focus and you will get a sharp output for your main object once you select the required appropriate focusing area and the focus mode. So same way, the other cameras like Canon, Sony have the same similar focusing systems. So you can make best use out of it and try to capture the sharper photographs. So that's all for today. I hope you got a good understanding about the focusing system. And now after this focusing system, there will be one more video which I'll be covering, which will be the last topic of our basic photography session, that is how to compose the photographs. So hope you are enjoying the sessions. If you have any questions, doubts, please feel free to post your questions or doubts in the comment box. If you have learned out of this video, please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe the channel if you are not subscribed, and hit the bell icon so that you get the notification of my new videos. So thank you so much, and bye for now.